you need your foam roller and a yoga mat. Today's going to be great. There's not going to be much, if any, standing at all. It's just going to be mushy, super mushy down on your mat. We're going to start with just to kind of ground down. You need your roller. Now, I do love this Manduka roller. If you have a longer roller, that's fine. This is the melt roller. It's a little bit softer. I know many people love the melt program. That one would work great for this whole next hour. And remember, well, for those of you who didn't get my email, I'm not going to be too concerned about time today. If we run out, I'm going to pop back on and start live up again because we have a 1 hour limit. So it might take me another 10 minutes or so to get through this. So pop up on your roller, sit on your roller if it's comfortable. The advantage to sitting down on the roller is that if we can get our hips down, our knees down below our hips. Now, this morning, my left knee doesn't want to really go out there, so I'm just going to extend my leg out and see if I can just try to get comfortable here. This is good. I want my pelvis to tilt forward. So we're just going to inhale, arms up. We just want to connect to our breath. And exhale, hands to heart center. You can close your eyes. You can keep open. Take a nice big breath up. Connect your palms and bring your hands back down to heart center. One more time. Inhale, arms up, look up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Great. Bring your hands, fingertips behind your ears. Inhale, open your elbows up nice and wide. You can do a little arch of the spine if you want, and you can knit your lower ribs in, and then have your elbows kiss from your chin to your chest. You get a nice stretch. So we've got 7 key exercises. We're going to work from the top of the body down. 7 key areas to roll. Take an inhale here. Exhale, elbows kiss. Inhale, open. So there's lots of different areas that we can foam roll. I've just chosen 7 that I think really represent the best spots in the body. If you can only hit 7, last time. Press up with your head. A little pull down with your fingertips. Get a nice stretch in between your shoulders. Relax your shoulders. Good. Let's do a little twist. So inhale, arms up. There we go. Now my hip wants to go down. So I've rolled pretty far forward. The roller is pretty far back. And just twist. Doesn't make a difference left and right today. You can do whatever you want. Just be sure that if you do something on the left side, you do it on the right side. And we'll twist. And take a nice big inhale up. And an exhale, twist. Try to have a nice long spine on your twisting. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, twist. Good, and then come back to the center. Come off of your roller, come onto your knees. Bring your roller under your fingertips on one side for a lateral stretch. Bring the other arm up. And inhale, just laterally stretch over to the side and come up. And stretch. So I'm pressing the roller away, getting a little bit of a massage on my wrist and on my fingers. Just do some lateral stretches to one side. Grab your roller, bring it to the other side. Plug the shoulder down. Lift the fingertips up. Try to square your shoulders, square your hips. No fast and hard rules with stretching. The only thing we want to make sure that we do is make our stretches more dynamic, which means we're moving, which is exactly what we're doing, and not static. Static stretches are for when our body is nice and warm. We're going to do some static stretches after each of our 7 key foam roller areas. Let's bring the roller out into the front. Bring your hands on with your thumbs facing up and just dive down. Oh, that feels so good. And then lift up, kind of like a cobra. Squeeze your shoulder blades together, tuck your chin. Dive down. Lift up. So when we foam roll, do a couple more of these. You don't have to use ujjayi breathing like we do in yoga, but I do want you to connect with your breath. So I want you to try to lengthen your inhales and lengthen your exhales and make them even. You can breathe in through the nose and out through the mouth if that is what feels good for you. Okay, let's turn sideways. Bring your hands onto the roller and bring your knees underneath your hips for a couple rounds of cat-cow. Now, putting your hands on the roller makes things very unstable. You are welcome to bring your hands down to the mat. Curl your back toes under. Let's stretch the fascia in the bottoms of the feet. Inhale, drop your belly, squeeze your shoulder blades together. gonna lift your chin. Big inhale here. Exhale, round, tuck and curl. Dome the spine. Press the mat or the roller away. Inhale, drop your belly. Make sure your wrists and elbows are right underneath your shoulders. Lift the chin, arch the spine, flare the glutes. Exhale, round, tuck and curl. Press that. Press down with your hands. Press with your knees. Curl your belly button in. Let's do one more. Inhale, drop the belly. Lift the chin. Cow pose. Cat pose. Big exhale. Here. Great. Come to a standing position. Hold your roller up in your hands. If you've got a nice tall roller, that's great. Nice long roller, that's great. Inhale here. Exhale, tuck your chin and roll down one vertebra at a time. Maybe your roller touches the ground. Bend your knees as much as you need to. Get your roller to touch the ground. Relax your head. Circle your neck out one way. Circle your neck out the other way. And then try to stack your spine one vertebra at a time. Your head's going to be the last thing to come up. Keep coming up. Relax the shoulders. Get more space between the shoulders and the ears. Chin comes up to parallel. Slight bend in the knees, bring the arms up overhead. Let's do that one more time. Arms down. When the roller comes to the thighs, just drag the roller down the body. Tuck your chin. Draw your belly button in. Shoulders are heavy. Ribs are heavy. Hips stay high. Lower all the way down. Take an inhale at the bottom. Exhale, roller travels up the body. Stacking your vertebrae one at a time. Slight bend in the knees. Bring the roller up overhead. Nice big inhale here. And an open mouth exhale. Okay, let's come down onto the mat. Grab your roller. We're going to start with our upper back and chest. So work the shoulders individually, but for now we're going to start with the upper back. So bend your knees, bring your feet flat, glide back onto your roller, and bring your roller to the top of the, above the shoulder blades. You can bring your hands behind your head. Don't interlace your fingers because I don't want you to pull on your neck. So your elbows are nice and wide. Just want you to keep your tailbone down, your glutes are going to stay down. You're going to arch your spine. So what we're doing is we're trying to compress the muscles and work the fascia, which is the connective tissue. So I'm just going to arch and come back up. And then I'm going to lift my hips and press. I'm going to bring the roller down one vertebra. I'm drawing my belly button in to protect my low back, knitting the low ribs so that I don't get a huge arch in the lumbar spine. There's already a little curve in the lumbar spine. Let's just keep that there. So we're just bending back, elbows are soft, head is soft in the hands, and after each one, I'm going to lift my hips, press with my feet, and bring the roller one more vertebra down. Oh, I'm right about the bra strap line. Wow, does this feel good. So I'm going to do a couple here. I want you guys to go at your own pace, but it needs to be slow. So the pace that I talk about means you moving from one exercise to the other. This feels really good for me, so I'm going to hang here. I'm going to bring one elbow to the hip, my elbow to the other hip, and I'm just going to do some movements here in this area. Then I'm going to bring the roller down one more. I'm keeping my chin slightly tucked, and I'm just gently and slowly arching back and then lifting up. Really important that you move slowly and that you breathe. Trying to undo and keep lifting your hips and rolling down. You're going to get to a point where it's going to be hard for you to breathe because you're pressing right on the back of your lungs. I want you to stop there. And at that point, I want you to lift your hips and lower your hips. And lift and lower. And the lifting and the lowering up into bridge and down is going to bring that roller up and down. So keep your hips down and see what it feels like to extend your arms up overhead and then bring your arms down. You can do one arm at a time if this is too hard on your neck. Maybe switch sides. And then get to a somewhat comfortable position. I'm going to roll so that my head is a little bit more supported. I'm going to bring my arms out like a T. palms face up, and even bring them overhead like a Y, and the roller supporting the back of my shoulders. I just want to get a nice big chest opener, pec opener here. So we want to undo any trauma or anything that could be stuck in our tight muscles or in our connective tissue. Our connective tissue is like one big giant piece of saran wrap that's connected, that's wrapped around all our muscles and bones and ligaments and tendons. And it has its own nervous system. It has a memory. And so it does store our emotions. Okay. So let's move the roller off to the side. Come to child's pose. Actually, that's not true. Hold on to your roller, and if you want to see how the front of your shoulders feel, bring your knees wide, bring your big toes to touch, and you can use your roller in child's pose. So you can rest your forehead on the roller if the mat seems very far away from you. You can bring your wrists on top of the roller and get more of a stretch here. And bring your forehead down onto the mat. You can bring the roller up closer to your elbows and bend your elbows, whatever is more comfortable for you here. For me, it feels good to have my fingers straight, my roller on my wrists, and sink in here. This is our deep stretch. We just stretched the back of the upper back. We've opened up through the chest. Now we can thread the needle. So you're going to weave one arm under. I like to keep the roller out in front so that it supports this hand that's out in front. Bring the ear to the mat and look over towards your outstretched hand. You should feel a nice stretch in the upper back. If you want more of a stretch, just try to roll onto the back of that shoulder just a little bit. You have to lift your hips to do that. Draw your belly button in. And let's switch sides. So start best by lifting up, bring your hands back onto the roller. If you're using a roller, you do not have to use your roller here. You can thread the needle just by bringing one shoulder under. The palm of the outstretched hand that you're looking at is facing up, and you can roll onto the back of that shoulder if that feels good. And take a couple breaths here. And then slowly release. Come up onto your knees, swing your legs around, bring your roller behind you. This is totally optional. I'm gonna weave a couple things in here that are kind of tricky, be for you advanced types out there that wanna challenge yourself. So we're just gonna do a reverse plank where we're gonna lift up with our hands behind us and our fingers facing out. The option here is to pop up onto your roller and do the same thing with your roller. But you want to squeeze your shoulder blades together, dial your toes down, press your toes into the mat, squeeze your shoulder blades together, and lift. And you can drop your head back, and then lower. You can try it both ways. You're probably going to get more height if your hands aren't on the roller, but if you feel like challenging your core, it's kind of a fun thing to do. Roller behind, reverse plank, opening up through the collarbones. So come down out of that, and we're gonna work to the shoulder. We're gonna work each shoulder individually. So I want you to lie on your side. Your roller is parallel with the top of the mat, perpendicular to your body. And I want you to lie on your side, bend your knees, comfortably stack your knees, and bring the roller right underneath your armpit. And then bring your head into your hands, but I want you to look back and pull this elbow back, so that the elbow is in line with the shoulder, shoulder is in line with the hips. So you might have to bump your hips back a little bit more towards the back of the mat. And all we're gonna do is we're gonna roll forward. You can bring that top hand anywhere you want. So the more you roll forward, the more you're gonna get the front of this pec. I'm gonna scoop over a little bit of my roller because I wanna roll back and roll to the back of my shoulder. So I'm going to show you a bunch of different techniques here. Try to keep your elbow down. So you're just rolling your body on the roller instead of rolling on the roller. Your option here would be to extend that bottom arm. And if you find a sticky spot, just bending and extending and moving the muscles that are in underneath there, you're really gonna feel this. So I like to call this like we're on a hunt. We're on a hunt for sensation. We're listening to our bodies, we're breathing, we're moving slowly enough so that we can feel a sticky spot. Like I got a sticky spot right here. It just is tough and crunchy and it's radiating all the way back into parts of my shoulder where I'm not even really moving. So I'm just gonna rest here and I'm gonna bend and extend my arm. I'm gonna do some little rocks back and forth above the spot and below the spot. And I'm gonna direct my breath, especially my exhales, to this spot. Fascia holds emotions that get kind of pent up. Like I said, it has this memory. And it's our job to assist with the healing and the releasing. And that's exactly what we're doing with this fascia release practice. Okay, so from here you've got a couple options. You can move the roller away from your rib cage and kind of explore toward your, a little bit more towards your tricep. You'll notice that when you go onto your back here, you're really gonna feel that here. And then the other thing is, we're gonna pull the roller in, and we're still gonna rock back and forth on our side, but we're gonna start working the intercostal muscles in between the rib cage. So I'm on my right side, so I'm gonna angle my roller so that the tip of the roller that I'm looking at is going to angle down towards my knees, and I'm still gonna rock back and forth, and I'm gonna go kind of rib by rib. You might have to give a little pressure. Give some pressure with your, you can come onto your forearm here. If you do a lot of abdominal work, a lot of abs, this could be super tender for you. You're just gonna roll back and forth. We've angled the roller so that it's at the same angle as our rib cage so that we can get those muscles in between. So we're just working our way down. This is all to open up our shoulder. So we'll stay here for a couple more breaths, maybe a minute or more or so. And I want you guys to search around and see what feels good. Maybe at the back of the shoulder, above the shoulder blade and around the shoulder blade, maybe that's what feels good for you. It can't really roll, it's kind of hard to roll in this position, but it's really good to use the roller as a compression instrument for us right here. We're compressing the muscle. When we apply pressure to a muscle, we're willing it to release. We're bringing heat from fresh blood flow to the compression of the muscle. And what we really want to do here is we're encouraging everything to relax. Okay, let's switch sides. Other side. Other armpit. Maybe scoot more to the front of your roller so that when you roll onto your back, you've got some roller behind you, especially if you have a short roller. Your head is resting gently in your hand. Pull your elbow back so that it's in line with your shoulder. I've got elbow, shoulder, hips. I'm gonna draw my belly button in just to protect my low back. And I'm gonna begin rolling forward and rolling back. Oh, that feels good. You can let your elbow lift up when you roll onto your back to get the back part of that shoulder. You can make little circles. You can kind of rock back and forth. Breathe and go slowly. Fascia responds to slow, steady movement and compression. If you're in too much pain in any of these areas, you could very well trick your fascia into thinking that there's trauma in that area and it's gonna lay down more muscle fibers, which is exactly the opposite of what we're trying to do. We're trying to find these, I'm gonna move this roller down and start working down the underside of the shoulder, back of the shoulder, and then I'm gonna angle it and start working these intercostal muscles, which are the little muscles that are in between each individual rib. So the slow movement and the slow motion that we're doing is that we're trying to undo the connective tissue areas where when the body
body perceives trauma and lays all these layers of connective tissue down, kind of like a band-aid. And it's our job to kind of search around, oh, like right here, search around through the body and find these sticky spots that might be incredibly painful and see if we can work around and release some of these bundles, some of these areas, some of these knots, if you want to call them. See if we can release them. By releasing them, we release emotional trauma, emotional issues, all kinds of memory. So I'm working my way down, and then I'm going to come back up, because I really want to work the back of the shoulder here and get all the way front into the pec muscle here. Couple more passes. So that's why deep tissue massage is good and yoga is good, because we compress the body, we work with our binds and all the movements, we work on our connective tissue and work to have it be in a nice, healthy, more liquidy state instead of it being dry and starved of hydration. So what we're doing is we're actually kind of hydrating here. Okay, so come to your knees and let's see how our shoulders feel. We'll do a little bit of eagle. So bring your arms out in front, bring one elbow underneath. Connect your palms, dial in your thumbs right in front of your nose or grab opposite shoulders. And from here, we're just going to release the elbows away from the body and then pull them in. And release and pull in. And lift up. And come down, elbows to the belly button. Let's lift the elbows up. Oh, my shoulders feel really good. And come down. A couple more lifts, and then let's actually just change the other side. So open nice and wide. Draw your fingertips back towards your elbows, slight bend in the elbows. Really stretch there. And other side, bring the other arm underneath, cross wrap twist, or grab opposite shoulders. And we're just going to round the spine and release the elbows away, and pull them in, and round and away, and lift the elbows, and slowly round, tuck and curl, bring the elbows down to the belly button, and lift. And lower. Great, let's come to forearm plank. You can be on your knees or you can be on your toes. You can clasp your hands. Actually, I'd like you to clasp your hands. And we're just gonna do some scapular push-ups. So I'm gonna let my lower body isn't gonna move at all. So I'm gonna keep my knees down just to demonstrate. I'm gonna let my chest dip down, I'm squeezing my shoulder blades together. And then I'm pressing through my forearms and my elbows and I'm doming through my spine. So I'm just going to drop my chest and press with my forearms and lift. These are called scapular push-ups or I guess shoulder blade push-ups, serratus push-ups. You can do the same thing on your hands in high plank. Nothing is going to move. I'm just going to dip my heart down. My elbows aren't bending. My legs aren't bending. All I'm doing is squeezing my shoulder blades together as my chest dips. Then I'm pressing with my hands and I'm wrapping my shoulder blades around. Pull your belly button in. So do a couple more of these. These are really good shoulder strengthening the muscles that control the shoulder blades, the scapula. Great. Okay, let's move down to our hips and our low back. So we're going to lie onto our back. Bend your knees, lift your hips, bring your roller underneath your sacrum. So that's not your low back, because you never want to put the roller where the lumbar spine curves, where the low back curves. You want to be just below that, but not on your glutes. So this is supported bridge. This is enough for a lot of people. This is a very, very comfortable position, but it is also a big stretch for people too. If you want to take it further, we're going to hug one knee in. So this knee is going to be, and this leg is going to be a lot more accessible than when our pelvis is down on the floor. So you're just going to hug the knee in. Option to extend the opposite leg with the heel on the mat. And your low back here. This can be, if this doesn't feel good on your low back, don't do it. Okay, so I like to bring my hands, I have a short roller, I like to bring them right on either side of the roller, just kind of hug it in. We're gonna come to reverse tabletop and just tick-tock the knees from side to side. You can bring your arms out a little bit wider with your palms face down if you're feeling unstable on your roller, and begin to make circles with your knees. So we're just rolling out the low back. Okay, dial your knees over to one side about 45 degrees and start to make circles. My knees are together, my ankles are together, and I'm trying to keep my knees in line with my hips. If I bring my knees in too close to my chest, I'm really not gonna feel it. If my knees are too far away, it's gonna put a lot of pressure and my low back is gonna start to arch. I don't want you to do that. Pause here and just make big circles with that bottom knee, the one that's closest to the mat. The other knee stays stationary. Make some circles, circle in the opposite direction, and then bicycle the knees back and forth. So I'm way off to the side because I want to hit that outer part of this hip. And that feels really good. I'm drawing my belly button in, and I'm breathing, and let's come back over to the other side. So drop your knees over, kiss the knees together, release the knees away so that you can kind of look and see, and you can also feel. You don't want the knees to be so far away. And if you're too high up, with your knees pointing too high up to the ceiling, change direction of your circles, and then you are going to pause the top knee and circle the bottom knee. The bigger the circle, the more you're gonna feel this. So if you're not off to an angle, you're not gonna hit the outer part of the hip. I just want you to work with whatever part of your body feels good, and then bicycle the knees in back and forth. Center, and we're going to hit the glutes later, but we're going to just kind of focus more on the low back here. So lift your hips and bring the roller out from underneath, roll over to one side. We're going to do cobra on the roller. So I want you to come down onto your belly with your legs out long behind you. And you're going to bring your hands out in front like Superman with your roller on your forearms. So dial your toes out to each side and bring your inner ankle into the mat. And I want you to press your inner ankles down, press your pelvis down, forehead is on the mat, take a nice big inhale here, and on an exhale, press into your roller and think about squeezing your shoulder blades down into your back pocket. Keep your chin slightly tucked, no arching up, no looking from side to side. Put your belly button in, nice big stretch, and then lower. Inhale at the bottom, exhale to lift. Inhale at the top, exhale to lower. Inhale at the bottom, exhale to lift. Option to bring one back of the hand to the forehead, do a little salute, little twist to the right, and then lower down. Inhale at the bottom, exhale, cobra lift, hand to the forehead, elbow is wide, twist to the other side, and dive down. Let's do one more each side. Inhale, lift. And open and dive. Inhale at the bottom, lift and open, and dive down. Great. Bring your hands up your roller, press yourself up. We're going to do mermaid. So bring your roller in front of you so that it's parallel to the top of your mat. Come to all fours. Drop down onto one hip and bring your knee over to one side of the mat and your hip right inside in line with that. So you've got a line with your thigh. If you were to pull your roller in, it would be right exactly the same shape and set up the same way as your roller. Knees are bent. I like to bring my front foot to my back knee. Now I'm going to flank the roller. So we're going to just add it on a little bit with the cobra work that we just did. So see if you can square your shoulders and bring that top hip around. Now if you're angled too much and your hip is back, you're really not going to feel this. So I want your hip and your knee line to look exactly like the same line as your roller. Slowly and carefully bring your
big inhale. Same thing we just did. Dive down.
Take an inhale at the bottom. I really feel this in my low back. Feels great. Draw your belly button in. Take it in. Take a nice big inhale. Exhale. Cobra rise. Straight arms. Draw your shoulder blades down.
Reach for the back ankle or the mat or the knee and lift up. So I've got my right hand back towards my ankle. And I'm going to bring my right shoulder forward, and I'm going to do a lateral stretch. Inhale here, exhale, dive.
Draw the belly button in. Inhale at the bottom, exhale. First we have a cobra lift,
just like we did before. Straight arms, square those shoulders, belly button in, and then twist. This time I'm going to bring my right hand to my left knee, and I'm going to do a lateral twist over this direction. Great, let's do the other side. I'm just gonna swing my legs around. And just so you can see me with the camera. So you're gonna start in all fours and bring the knee over towards behind the wrist so that you can line up on the other side. Thigh is parallel with the roller. Roller is parallel with the short end of the mat, perpendicular to the long end of the mat. I gotta know your math in here. Okay. Flank your roller, bring your hands on either side of the roller, and spend some time here, and breathe. This might be enough for you. This is a big hip twist, this is a big stretch. We've got an internal rotation of the hip, we've got an external rotation of the hip. Bring the hands up on the roller, take a nice big inhale. When you're ready, you're gonna slowly dive down. I'll straighten my wrists and my forearms, and my hands are. My forehead reaches down for the mat, but I wanna keep my knees connected. Take an inhale at the bottom, exhale. It's like I have an orange underneath my chin. And I'm trying to drag my shoulders down and get them as far away from the top of my head as possible. I'm gonna lift, plant the hand, reach and twist over. And I'm gonna spin and dive down.
Inhale at the bottom, exhale. First get your cobra in.
It's like up dog. And then bring your twist. And release. Take your roller out of the way. We're just going to do a little bit of stretching, even though that was a little bit more stretching and not as much rolling. So let's come to bird dog. Actually, grab your roller if you want to make this a little bit more difficult. Your hands are on the mat. They're underneath your shoulders. Your knees are underneath your hips. You're going to extend one leg back and extend the opposite arm forward and lift those toes up off the mat. Take an inhale here. Draw your belly button in and round, tuck, and curl. Bring your chin to your chest. Try to bring your thigh as close to your chest as you can and bring your elbow right to your knee. The option here is to bring your hand on top of your roller. Make sure it's directly underneath your shoulder. This is really going to challenge your balance. So inhale, lift the thumb, lift the heel. Exhale, round, tuck, and curl. You're going to have to press down on that roller. Bring the thigh real close to the chest. Chin right to the chest. Let's do one more. Inhale. Lift the heel, lift the thumb, lengthen through the crown of the head, lengthen through your neck, round, tuck, and curl. Now if the roller's too far in front of you and your shoulder isn't stacked over your wrist, this is going to be really hard to do. Let's change and do the other side. So I'll start with my hands off the roller. I'm going to extend the other leg, dial the toes down. Arm is extended, thumb is up. Lift the heel. Inhale. Lift the heel, lift the thumb. Your gaze is straight down, right at your roller if you've got it there or right in front. Round, tuck, and curl. Bring that knee up as high towards the chin as possible. Kiss the elbow to the knee. Knee pushes in, elbow pushes in. Release. Lift the thumb, lift the heel. I'm going to pop up onto my roller. I'm going to bring it under so I make sure that my wrist is underneath my shoulder. Lift. Exhale, curl. Last one, you guys. Inhale, lift. Exhale, curl. Great. And then slowly release. Okay, let's move on to our glutes. You've got your roller. Bring it behind you. And sit on it. Okay, so people like to do this one backwards. Bring your hands behind you. Puff up through the chest and the shoulder blades engaged. I'm gonna bring my right ankle on top of my left thigh. Now I'm gonna drop my right knee over to the right. I'm gonna scoop my butt over so that now I've kind of exposed my glute on this side. And I'm just gonna bend and extend my left knee, and I'm gonna roll. And I wanna roll the whole part of that glute. I'm gonna roll down towards my sit bone. You'll know when you feel it. I'm on a seam here in the garage, up the floor. Okay, so I'm gonna roll the length of the glute here, or I can rock from side to side. But I wanna stay twisted over here. Now, if you have a hard time in figure four, just bring both feet onto the mat and drop your knees over to one side. And that's gonna help you expose the, especially the glute knee. Now the great thing about this is that we can kind of get up a little bit higher to what I like to call like the waistband line. You see I've come down onto my forearm, but my elbow is right underneath my shoulder and I'm engaging my belly. And I'm gonna work the outer part of the hip and then work down into the glute. Make sure you're breathing. And in this area, close your eyes. I want you to be, and I want you to listen to your body. See if you can find a little area that makes the hair on your back and your neck start to stand up. Or maybe it flashes in a memory or an emotion, or you feel it someplace else in your body. I want you to work that area right there. Okay, so your options are that you can sweep your leg. You can bend and extend. If you're in figure four, you can make little circles, just move around and get into that glute. And I'm gonna pop right over and go to the other side. I'm gonna turn around so you guys can just sit right in your roller. And you can drop over to the other side. So you can drop your knees down or come to figure four and bump your hips over and then drop the knee down towards the mat. People like to go in the opposite direction and it's okay, but it's not as effective as moving the muscles around by putting our leg and our hip into this position. It really helps to expose those glute muscles. So I'm gonna rock from side to side. If I feel a particularly sticky spot, I'm gonna sweep my leg, or I'm gonna bend and extend, and I'm gonna explore all the way in towards my tailbone, all the way out towards the hip, breathing. And then I like to get high up into the waistband area, outer hip, and I'm sort of working, bending, extending, and sort of working right around that hip bone. Trying to stay off the bone, but I like to work around the edge of the hip bone. That feels good. Belly is in. Okay, so let's press the roller. Keep your roller near, and let's do a stretch. So lower yourself down onto your back. Cross one knee over the other, cross one thigh over the other. Take your hands, bring your knees as close to your body as you can, keeping your head, neck, and shoulders on the mat. Grab shins, ankles, or the outer edges of your feet. Pull up with your feet, pull down with your hands and elbows, down and out. And meanwhile, stamp your glutes and your low back down onto the mat. Pull your belly button in towards the mat. Pull your knees into your chest. Big glute stretch here. See what it feels like to drop your heels down, but keep rolling your hips down away from your head. Pulling in, and then let's switch sides. Ooh, that feels good. So I like to pull my knees apart once I've brought my thigh over, and I'm gonna lift, pull, separate, and stretch. Iron out that low back, iron it out, bring it down. Big breaths. Lots of tension to release from the hips and the glutes. Just let it all go.
Big inhale. Big exhale. Great. And release. Bring your feet down to the mat. Roll your knees over to one side. Press yourself up. We're going to go to our hip flexors. So take your roller, your hip flexor is the top of the quad right here in front, kind of up near the hip bone. So I'm going to move my roller up to one side of the mat, and I'm going to lay on, it's on my left side, my right knee is slightly bent, and I'm just going to work the top of the quad right below the hip, and I'm going to bend and extend my knee, and just let my pelvis be nice and heavy, and work kind of the top of the quad. We're going to get into the quads next, so stay high on the hip flexor. And you can just kind of bend and extend that leg, wiggle your butt from side to side, maybe wiggle your ankle from side to side, and then we're going to go right to the other side. So I don't have the roller going all the way across because I want to have control with this other knee because it's helping between pressing into my elbows and pressing into that other leg. Kind of helping me control how much weight is on this. Your hip flexors, if they're super tight, this can be quite painful. I'm going to bend and extend this knee. This feels good. Okay, great. So swing around and lie onto your back. Lift your hips. Bring the roller underneath your sacrum. That's not your glutes and it's not your low back. It's that bony plate, kind of, that's just above your tailbone, bottom of your back, back of your pelvis. Okay, walk your feet in so that they're kind of close to your roller. I want you to imagine that you're pushing on a ball in between your knees. Lift up one knee and hug that knee in towards the chest. So the other foot, this knee likes to flop out to the side. I don't want that to happen. I want you to press down at the base of the big toe and instep. So I'm hugging my left knee in. I'm pressing my instep of my right foot down. So now I'm gonna tuck my tailbone like I'm trying to zip up skinny jeans. I'm hugging my elbows in. I'm gonna press my right foot down and my right knee, I'm gonna press forward as I hug my left knee in. Big hip flexor stretch, big quad stretch. Now release, we're gonna release and switch sides. So slowly begin to hug this knee in towards the chest. And if you go slowly enough, you're eventually going to start to feel a big stretch on that quadricep of the, like right now I'm bending my right knee, but my left foot is on the floor. And the more I slowly pull this knee in, I'm really starting to feel a stretch through my quadricep. So I don't want to take it too fast because I might miss something along the way. So I haven't tucked my tailbone yet. I'm not doing any crazy knee presses away. But eventually, I'm going to scoop my belly like I'm trying to get more of my vertebra down onto the mat, which is impossible because we're elevated with a foam roller. And I'm hugging the knee in. Now my left foot is on the floor. I'm going to press down with my foot and press my left knee slightly away as I scoop my belly. It's a slight little scoop of the belly. It's nothing crazy here. And then slowly release, lift your hips, bring the roller out from underneath, and let's do a deep stretch. Bend your knees, bring your feet flat. You can do anything you want with your arms, and I want you to windshield wiper your knees from side to side. Those of you with tight hips, all this hip work is going to feel really, really good. Okay, pause with your knees over to the right. Walk your left foot over to the left. Just till you start to feel the outer part of your mat. The goal is to line up your knee with your hip and your hip with your shoulder. And then pick up the right foot and bring it on top of that knee to accentuate the hip flexor stretch. And just breathe here. Relax your knees. The further this top foot is over to the other, to the bottom ankle, the more of a stretch you're going to feel. Want even more of a stretch? This, my left foot that's down on the mat, I'm going to walk it and scoot it it a little bit further to the left. Just until I start to really feel the stretch in the psoas here, it's in the front of the hip. Now I want to relax my glutes and relax my hips and relax both knees. Take an inhale here, big exhale. One more time. Let's inhale something that you'd love to let go of, and let's let it go right now. And switch sides. Slowly release. Ooh, that's a big stretch. Heel toe that foot back onto the mat. And you can do a little mini windshield wiper from side to side. Spread your feet at least mat's width. Toes are slightly in, heels are slightly out. Knees fall to the other side. I'm going to walk this foot slightly off the mat. I like to look up down my body and see what's going on. I want my knee in line with my hip. I'm going to pick this foot up. And I'm just going to rest it down. Just let everything go on your exhale. Direct your exhales to any tension that you feel right now. There's a lot going on with this hip, in this hip flexor, and the glute, and the quad. Lengthen your exhales, deepen and pull your belly button in at the bottom of the exhale, and see if you can just release the tension, let it go, give it permission, take one more inhale, big exhale. Release that top foot. Slowly begin to heel toe that foot back onto the mat. Tiny broken bridge. Feet are wide, just let your knees fall in and take a rest. Whew, that's a deep stretch. There's a lot going on. Close your eyes. Acknowledge any feelings or emotions or memories that might be bubbling up. Hold on tight to the good ones and just let the other ones go. Okay, extend your legs out long. Just pick up one foot, think about figure four, and bring that ankle on top of that quad, right below between the quad and the knee, just not on your knee. And let the bent knee just relax down to the mat. There's your hip flexor, there's your outer hip and your glute. A couple breaths here. Stay here if it feels good. Or slowly extend the leg all the way down to the other one. Feet come together. Extend the legs that long. Bring the other ankle just above the extended leg's knee. If you want, you can bring your hand onto that thigh and encourage it out. Relax your shoulders. Even walk your shoulder blades together. Puff up through your heart. If you want a shoulder stretch, you can outstretch your arms like a Y. You turn your head to one side, turn your head to the other side. Heavy knee, release the glute. This glute likes to lock up. This outer hip likes to lock up. Okay, ready to move on to number six. We're going to go to our quads. Extend that leg long. Drag the foot down. Bend your knees. Roll over to one side. Press yourself up. Swing your legs around, you're going to come to a forearm plank, and your quads are going to be on your roller. So your forearms are going to provide, it helps with how much pressure is going to be on these quads. So you can point your toes, and you can roll the whole length of the quad. You don't have to worry about too high up, because we just did our hip flexors. So I'm going to move my roller down a little bit. So you don't want to roll your knees. You never want to go directly underneath. So think about what the quadricep looks like. Go to the bottom of the quad. And you know what? You're going to know it when you're at the bottom of that quad because you're going to be able to feel it. The muscle attachments at the ends of the muscles tend to be really, really sensitive. So I'm right at the bottom of my quads. I'm going to relax, but I'm pressing through my elbows and rounding through my scapula, my shoulder blades. It's like when we were doing those scapula push-ups. I don't want to just collapse down. The belly button is in. I'm going to bend and extend one side, one leg, and I'm going to bend and extend the other leg. Then I'm going to roll an inch or two, put the roller in a different part of my quads, and I'm going to bend and extend. I'm going to show you guys a bunch of different things that you can do here with your quads. So you can bend and extend one leg at a time. You can bend both knees and rock the soles of your feet. Are pointed straight up towards the sky. You can rock your feet from side to side. And again, if you travel up and down the quadricep, there's four muscles in there. We've got inner quads. So if you bring your heels together and your toes apart and try to spread your legs as wide as you can on your roller and you begin rolling, you're going to really feel your inner quad, right? And you can do the same thing. You can bend and extend. Ow! So this would be what I would say when my class is with everybody. No scary faces. I don't want you to roll on any connective tissue or muscles where you're in so much pain that you're clenching your face and you can't breathe. I need you to be able to talk. I need you to be able to breathe. You need to be able to sing. And that's what's going to keep us in that range where, yeah, pain is okay. It just needs to be pain that we can breathe through comfortably. If you can't breathe through it comfortably, then you've gone too far. And again, I don't want to keep driving this home. But I don't want this to be counterproductive and have the body produce more layers of connective tissue in an area because we're experiencing so much pain. Bring your toes together and your heels apart. I'm trying to work to the outer part of the quad. The other thing you can do is just roll slightly sideways. You're going to get the inner quad on one leg. You're going to get the outer part of the quad on the other side. And you can just kind of turn your torso slightly. You can do your quads single leg. You can do them both at the same time. You can roll the length of the muscle. But what I really like to do is just kind of wiggle my butt from side to side and work the length of the muscle, but work cross fiber. And the muscle tissue and connective tissue really responds well to the cross fiber motion. It's not a repetitive pattern that it's seen before, and it really responds well to that. So take a nice big breath. Okay, one last thing that you can do is you can reach back and you can grab one foot and bring your heel to your glute. Depends on where the roller is on your quad as to how comfortable this feels. Hug the other heel into the glute. Okay, and let's release that out, sit up, bring your legs nice and wide. And bring your roller out in front and just begin to come forward, just a wide angle forward fold. Get the inner thigh that we were just working when our feet were angled. And we had kind of moved around so that we were getting those inner thigh quad muscles, or the inner part of the quad. Great, and then sit up. Okay, so we're gonna stretch the quad. I'm gonna take my roller, I'm gonna sit on it underneath my left glute. If you have a long roller, that's perfectly fine. I just don't want it to be, I want you to step. I'm stepping my left foot forward so that my ankle is underneath my knee. My right leg is in half hero's pose, half virasana. I'm gonna bring my hands down to the mat. My knee stays connected to the mat. So if this is really uncomfortable for you, do another quad stretch. You don't have to do this. You might have to lift your hip up a little bit more. You can even do this not with your hip elevated on the roller. So I'm going to keep my right shin, the top of my right foot, and my right knee down on the mat. And I'm just going to bend my elbows, press the knee down and away, pull pull my belly button in and get a nice quad stretch. And you can come back as far as you want, as long as this knee stays down on the mat. So you can spread your hands out nice and wide and have your arms be straight. If that will give you a little bit more extension, pull the belly button in, no arching of the spine. Or you can just stay up nice and more on the tall side and bend the elbows like a tricep dip. Reach the knee away. Don't let the hip come up off the heel. And then let's switch sides. So I'm first just going to kneel. So I'm sitting right on my roller, and the roller's right on my sit bone. I'm going to step my other foot forward and push, pull that roller over so that it's just underneath my right butt cheek. My left knee is forward. My left toes are facing back. So I'm going to bend my elbows, draw my belly button in, kind of like a tricep dip here. I'm pressing my knee that's on the mat needs to stay connected. So that's what tells you how far back you want to go, how far back you're going to be able to go. And spread your fingers wide and lean back if that feels good. See what it feels like to do a little mini arch of the spine and then a little mini tuck of the pelvis. That can really change the quadricep stretch as well. And then slowly press yourself up, bring your roller off to the side, come down onto your belly. We're going to do a single floor bow. Another big stretch. So start with both arms out in front. Reach back with one arm. This is my right arm. I'm going to bend my right knee and grab the top of my right foot from the outside. I've just rolled to the left. I'm going to roll back down onto both hips. I'm going to press my hips down, keep my chin down, and kick into my hand by driving my right hip down, lifting my quad, lifting my knee. Option is to press through the hand and lift the torso. Other option is to lift that arm up off the mat. Now that only takes an incredible amount of low back strength. If that bothers your low back, put your hand back on the mat. Hug your knees into the midline, kick, 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 and release. Other arm out in front. Other hand reaches down from the outside. Hug the knees into the midline. So my right foot is going to press down on the mat. I'm going to kick into my left hand with my left foot, but I'm drawing my knees into the midline and I want to keep my left hip down. I'm going to kick, 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 lifting my chin but keeping it tucked and lifting the upper arm, the top arm, if that feels good. No crunching in the low back, pull your belly button in, pull your belly button in, kick, 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 knee comes up a little bit higher. And release. Bring one cheek to the mat. You can windshield wiper your legs from side to side. We've got one more area to go. We're working our way down into our calves. Press yourself up. I think we're going to run out of time. So like I said before, I'm going to restart this. Because I really don't want to miss anything. So with our calves, you can put both calves on your roller with your hands next to you, and you can keep your hips down and just roll from side, rock your to your feet from side to side. This is the cross fiber work. I'm going to start at the top of my calf, go to the middle of my calf, and then I want to work all the way down. And I don't feel much. Now the big meaty calf muscle, that's the gastroc. You're going to feel this without lifting your hips or doing anything, probably. So then your other option is to lift your hips and roll from side to side. Can be kind of hard on the shoulders. The other option is to stack one leg over and you can roll and do the same thing we did before. Roll your body. Whoop. You can also just press with one, bend one knee, and really work. I want you to get down real low and internally rotate, so toes are in, and externally rotate. I want you to work all the way down to the back of the ankle. We'll cross the ankles and press. I really want you to work. There's a little muscle down there called the soleus, and it attaches to the Achilles tendon. The soleus is below the gastroc, so it's kind of deep in there. It's a smaller calf muscle. Give some pressure. So my hips are down. I'm pressing with
with my top foot and I'm rocking from side to side. And then I'm going to do some little bends and extends and work my way all the way up through this calf muscle. Whew. I am sweating up a storm. So that's what we're doing, is we're hydrating the muscles, we're hydrating our connective tissue, and we're heating the whole body up. Okay, let's do the other side. So I'm going to cross over, I'm going to cross fiber and roll. Just play around, see what feels good. Oof. I'm going to internally rotate. Oh, I got a spot right in there. But I'm going to push with this top ankle and this top leg to get a little bit more pressure so that I can really get in there. I'm dialing my toes to the right, which means I'm getting the inside of the back of this calf. And then I'm going to externally rotate. And I'm exploring all the way around this ankle. It feels good. Rocking from side to side. I'm going to do a couple more passes. Great. Okay, press your roller off to the side. Keep it close. We're going to do one final forward fold. But let's find downward facing dog. So this is where you're really going to feel your open cast. So come to tabletop, spread your fingers nice and wide, walk your knees back, lift your hips well over your toes, walk your dog. So you want to bend one knee and bring the other heel down to the mat. I want you to really stretch out that calf muscle. This is a time when we can do what we call static stretching. So you can hold the stretch because you're warm. This is what you can lift your toes, drive through the heel. You can press with your hands, bring your torso a little bit closer towards your thighs. Bend your knees as much as you need to here, but then I want you to straighten out the leg so that you can really feel the stretch in the calf. That's what we're here for. We're here for the calf stretch right now. Pick up one foot and bring those toes onto the opposite heel. Keep pressing with your hands, slight bend in the knees, but pressure on that heel, so a little bit more stretch through the calf. And then switch sides. Lift up those toes, drop them down on your heels. Slight bend in the knee. Lift through the hips. And take an inhale here. Exhale, slowly lower down to your knees. Swing your legs out in front. We're going to do a forward fold. That's going to then bring us to Shavasana. So, take your roller, bring it on top of your outstretched legs, and forward fold. So my forearms are on my roller, my chin comes to my chest. There's two ways to forward fold here. I'm going to actually grab onto the tops of my toes from above, and I'm going to point my toes and flex my ankles. So I'm going to dorsiflex and plantar flex through the ankle. So right now my legs are straight and I'm kind of rounded forward. You can bring your roller real close to your body and that will help if you have super tight hamstrings. You can lose the roller altogether and do whatever feels good. So right now my legs are straight and my spine is rounded. I actually like to hug into the roller. This feels good here. I'm going to take the roller, I'm going to put it underneath my knees so that I have a slight bend in my knees, and I'm going to come down with a flat back. So I'm going to squeeze my shoulder blades together. It's almost like I've got a rod behind me, and the only thing that's going to change is my hip hinge here. So I'm pulling my heart back, I'm pulling my chin back as my torso comes forward. Towards my knees and drape forward. Big calf stretch, hamstring stretch, low back stretch. Inhale here and exhale. Use your hands on your feet to pull and round forward.
slowly come out. Close your eyes, bring your hands to the mat. Slowly press yourself up to a tall seated position. Scoop down so that your heels are at the bottom of your mat. If you're not already there, keep your roller underneath your knees. Start to walk your hands back. Lower down onto one forearm, lower down onto the other forearm, and like all the way back. Oh, you can walk your heels a little bit closer, and then just let your toes flop out to the side. Walk your shoulder blades together, palms face up. Lots of options here for Shavasana. And bring one hand to your heart and one hand to your belly. Giving yourself a hug. Hug your elbows in close to your body. Close your eyes. And draw your attention to what's happening in your body and any feedback it might be giving you right now. You might feel a swirling sensation in your body or hovering just above it. That's your energy field. Feel your pulse or your heartbeat in your fingertips or your toes or beneath your hands. You're feeling warmth and a new openness. You've had an hour of rolling, releasing, recovering, healing, detoxing. Encouraging collagen formation, hydrating the skin all the way through into every muscle fiber. It's like the Tin Man taking the oil can and working every part of the body. We'll finish with a few rounds of three count breath. So take an inhale, full inhale. And a full exhale. Now on this next inhale, we're going to take two pauses. Inhale about a third of the way. Pause. Inhale the second third of the way. Pause. Inhale the rest of the way. Pause. Exhale a third of the way. Pause. Exhale a third of the way. Pause and exhale all the way. Now, if that started to make you nervous, I want your holds to be so tiny that if somebody was looking at you, they wouldn't see you holding your breath. So take an inhale and pause twice before you come to the top of your inhale. On your own breath in your own time. And when you exhale, I want you to pause twice before you come to the bottom of your exhale. Three-part breath. Very common to the central nervous system. Tapping into our parasympathetic nervous system, our rest and digest. The stronger that nervous system is, the more we tap into it, the better able we are of getting out of our stressful state. Stressful state is not always bad. What's bad is when we get stuck there. So we need to be able to pop out of that as quickly as possible. And that's what we do in here. We strengthen all those things that help us stay in a rested and relaxed state as much as possible. Reach your arms up overhead. Biggest stretch of the day. Point your toes, big huge stretch. Bend your knees, maybe press your roller off to the side, roll over onto one side, use your bottom bicep as a pillow. Your eyes stay closed, slowly press yourself up to a seat. Swing your legs around in front, bring your hands to heart center. Little bow of the chin forward. Just to seal our practice with an inhale and an exhale. Taking a moment of gratitude for all those things that pop into your head and come into your heart. And bring to mind one thing you can take off this mat with you out into the day and share with others. Thank you very much for being with me. Namaste. Hope you have a wonderful day.